Well, this is a joint work with Professor Alfredo Yusin, who was my advisor here at IMPA and didn't give up of me, not yet. So the outline of the talk, you can follow it at the top of the page. I try to recall some basic details in fixed point method, and after that in monotonicity and some extensions. Then we are trying to present a new class of, let's say, a class of set-valued operators that we called QL. And after that, we're going to deal with the problem of finding a fixed point of this kind of operators. So, let's start by the successive approximation methods applied to contraction mappings. And of course, the Banach fixed point theorem asserts that the sequence of successive approximations strongly converge to the unique fixed point of such. Sorry? Yeah, I'll try to keep in time. But if you try to deal with, I mean, more general mappings like non-expansive mapping, then you have to do something else to get convergence. For example, the idea of month method. They use the idea of this method is to generate the next iterate using a convex combination with the previous iteration and T of xk, where T is the non-expansive mapping. So look that, of course, if you are dealing with the problem of finding a fixed point of T, it's equivalent to find a zero of the operator identity minus T. And here you can find this new, let's say, this iterator here is based on a regularization of the operator identity minus T. And this algorithm generates weakly convergence sequence, of course, assuming existence of a fixed point of the non-expansive mapping T. Assuming now that C is closed and also convex. In this case, there are some counterexamples. I mean, it is not possible to ensure a strong convergence of the sequence of iterates. Well, another idea is you can find this paper from Nakaha and Takahashi. The idea is to use the man's iteration to construct some sets. This part of the set is in fact a separating hyperplane, and then the next iterate is a projection over this set, and with this modification, the sequence converges to the closest fixed point. I mean, with respect to the initial iterates. Of course, if there are, in fact, fixed points. And another modification is provided by this work of Mudafi. The idea is to use here some kind of regularization using a strict contraction mapping. So the and of course, look here. We have an implicit method. In this case, there is supposed to prove strong convergence too. And we want to observe that. I mean, I would like to show you this is equivalent to this iteration here. So. Look, if T is non-expansive, the identity minus T is a monotone mapping, and here we have a strongly monotone mapping. So we have a regularization of the operator identity minus T, and the methods can also be seen as some kind of projection method, like the previous one. Using some separation hyperplanes. So we are going to consider here a set mapping operator. The set C will be the whole Hilbert space, real Hilbert space. And we are going to say that P is a fixed point. If P is an element of the set, here is sorry is well it's a fixed point if P is an element of the set T of P. And I said sorry because here is written our basic scheme, but of course it's a proximal point methods, of course, applied to the operator identity minus T. But the point is here, the idea is to work with operators, with a class of operators that where the identity minus T is not necessarily monotone. That is, T is not needed to be non-expansive. Okay? This is the point that we want to deal with. This class we are going to, I mean, QL class that we want to present here. So I mentioned once again that both methods use a monotonicity, in fact, of the operator identity minus T. So let's move to the point of this review of monotone operator and some extensions. Well, the notion of monotonicity you've seen here a few times, and maximality, well, is the graph cannot be extended properly while keeping the monotonicity property. Remember here the Mintz's theorem that establishes that a maximum monotone operator, for a maximum monotone operator, the regularization T plus lambda E is onto, and this new operator or regularized operator has Lipschitz continuous inverse, and the Lipschitz constant is given by the 1 over lambda. One extension is a raw hypomonotonicity. Here I'm using a reference from Penane. The idea is the inner products need not to be non-negative. We let it to be negative, just using this distance here that depends on the primal variables. So one important point here is that, let's say, the monotonicity property is a graph symmetrical property. Okay, an operator T is monotone if and only if its inverse is monotone. The same is not true for hypomonotone operators. It's a property that depends on the primal variables or in the dual variables. Of course, it stays hypermonotone with parameter rho, then T plus rho identity is a monotone operator, so that we can regularize. And if now lambda is bigger than rho, then we still have a regularized operator with inverse Lipschitz with this constant. So at this point, I'll mention the proximal, I mean, what is this slide here is a hybrid proximal extragradient method, allowing for a relative error tolerance. This error here or this error here. And I'm using this reference by using Penanen and Zweite. Look, here we have an inclusion, which is the proximal subproblem, which is solved approximately with some kind of error. And then we are using an extra, they are using this extra gradient step. This method, well, for me, is one of the most complete versions of this idea of proximal point method. And if T has zeros, then the sequence is weakly convergent to a zero of T. So this method is designed for finding zeros of maximal monotone. I mean, for a maximal hypermonotone operator with respect to the dual variables. I mean, the inverse of T is a maximal rho hypermonotone. So we would like to explore this method to find zero of this class of operators that we call QL. So our class that we are going to present soon is based in an idea that Garcia and Eusen, we discussed in a previous paper, which we call a rho semi monotone operator. Here, semi is just because we didn't find any other publication with this modification, semi, okay? Just the name. Well, the idea here is to relax monotonicity, but now considering both primal and dual variables simultaneously, so that we get a class which is graph symmetric. Okay. And of course, maximality, keeping the property, I mean, we cannot extend properly the graph of the operator. So there are these three magic functions here. I will just to mention that, well, of course, rho here must be between 0 and 1. 0 is the case of monotonicity. 1 is the case of anyone. I mean, any operator is one semi-monotone. Anyone. Okay? So rho here is from 0 to 1. Then beta is a function, is a positive function in this interval. This is increasing up to 1, and eta is a decreasing function plus infinity to 1. So what we should recall about this tension? An operator T, a set valued operator T, is semi-monotone. If this operator here is gamma hypermonotone. Yeah, beta and gamma given by those formulas there. Okay. Same from maximality, and 3 and 4 are what I think I can say is extension of the Mintis theorem. If we choose lambda in this interval, then a semi-monotone operator can be regularized, and the regularized, in fact, this inverse is Lipschitz continuous, and we can, in fact, give the Lipschitz constant. And if T, in fact, is maximal rho semi-monotone, then this operator is onto. I mean, okay. Remember, the Minkowski theorem says that for any rho, any positive rho, the operator T plus lambda E is surjective and has inverse, which is Lipschitz. So now we can say that the operator T is rho, maximal rho semi-monotone if the operator T plus lambda E in this interval this operator is onto and has inverse given by this Lipschitz constant. In fact, back to the case, when rho equals zero, we have the whole positive line. When rho goes to one, the interval collapses just to with one element in one. Okay. Well, I think I have to move forward quickly. So we are the class. We are saying that the operator, set valued operator T is QL with some parameter tau. It satisfies this property here, which is a strongly convex combination of the distance in primal and dual variables. The same for maximality. And one lemma, if F is non-expansive, then F satisfies property QL for any tau in the interval 0, 1 over 2. We have no time for this is already published. You can look the details in the article. If F is expansive, then F is also an element of the class with some choice of the parameter. Since this function there, 1 over tau minus 1, goes from 1 to plus infinity in the interval 0, 1, 1 half, then any expansion will be an element of this class. The graph in this class is closed, and it contains a symmetric class, which is just the inverse of any, additive inverse of any semi-monotone operator. The class QL is not graph symmetric, of course, but it contains a subclass that is graph symmetric, which are the operators that satisfy this property here. Maximum is XQL, the same idea as maximality. Already mentioned that it's symmetric. And of course, I also mentioned that it's contained in the QL class. Of course, it's the QL class is a bigger class. For example, the identity is an element in QL, but it's not an element in SQL. This is not important now. We can characterize the operators in this two class looking the graph of the operators. Okay. I just move on, because we are out of time. This is perhaps something that we should look carefully. We have a maximal element in the symmetric part of the class, then it has a unique fixed point. It can be shown. I skip the proof of that. Moreover, any maximal element in the symmetric path generates an operator identity minus t that has inverse, which is hypermonotone, maximal hypermonotone for some parameter that we can compute in terms of the parameter rho. So that the proximal Hilbert proximal point method of using Penrose-Weiter can be applied at least for this class of operators to find zeros. I mean, to find zeros of identity minus t, which is the same as finding a fixed point of an operator in this class. Well, the same is not true for elements in the bigger class, but we can identify each element of the QL class with an element of the symmetric part of the class, so that we can explore this idea to get convergence of the proximal point even in the class. Of course, first we have to pass through an element in the symmetric class, and then we get convergence. But we can write it directly on the method, just modifying the method appropriately. That's the idea. So this is the identification here, exactly in terms of the parameters. In fact, the element that represents the operator in the class QL is just parametrization of the operators, then we move to the class of symmetric QL elements. Well, if you define this matrix L here or this matrix M here, then the operator T is an element of the QL class if and only if the matrix L is positive semi-definite. This is the case when T is an affine mapping given by this matrix A. And T is an element of the symmetric part of the class if and only if the matrix M is positive semi-definite. Of course, it can be given in terms of engineering values too. Okay. So the same, the non-smooth case can also be identified using the matrix with a defined with the Jacobian matrix and so on. But let's go to the problem of finding the fixed point methods in the class QL. Okay? So here, don't worry about it. It's just the Hilbert proximal point method. Of course, rewriting appropriately to behave with this class of operator. We still is here. We have solving an inclusion approximately, satisfying some error criteria with error of relative kind, and an extra step which is, well, this is the approximately proximal solution minus the error. But this is it's equivalent to let's say the step over k with an element in t of sk, tilde sk. So don't worry about it. It's just, we can do it. And we are able to recover what is already done. I mean, we get weak convergence to a fixed point, provided there are, in fact, fixed points. And in the symmetric class, we can rewrite the algorithm appropriately. And in this case, we can get strong convergence. That's it. Main reference. Bosque Montosca, Anreich, Garcia and Yusin, with this paper concerning semi-monotone operators. I don't know if you have access to this journal. I think it's a local journal, computational. You know, computational applied mathematics. I think it's those elements. The semi-monotone. No. This paper is already appeared, I mean, two or three months ago. And it's in JOTA, okay, yeah. Journal of Simulation Theory and Applications. General Strauss, there, concerning the contrast samples, where you have only weak convergence and not strong convergence, those previous fixed point methods. The work of Fuse and Penna and Svite concerning the irreproximal point method, the work with the Mann's method, the work of Mudafi concerning strong convergence of to find fixed point method, and also Takaho Takahashi, Nevlarin and Reich, here the work of Professor Reich. Okay, that's
exact. Thanks to the speaker. Will we skip the questions? I'm sorry.
Well, it was not my fault.
Sorry.
I started.
No, sorry, it was mine.